So here what I've created is an implementation of the subspace iteration. Now, how I got here was simply to take the last implementation of the power method and copy that over and then make a few changes. In particular, I pass in matrix A and the matrix V. V now is a matrix where the columns are going to hold the approximations for the eigenvectors. And I'm also going to pass back both V and a matrix that is going to give us some indication of what the eigenvalues are. In particular, it'll eventually become a diagonal matrix where the eigenvalues can be found on its diagonal. Now, the important things here are that I now track n eigenvalues. N is the number of columns in matrix V, so that I can plot them. I initially take my matrix V, which was a random matrix, and I make it into a matrix that has mutually orthonormal columns, where I only want n of those mutually orthonormal columns, and that's where the option 0 comes in when you pass that into the QR factorization algorithm that MATLAB provides. And then we start iterating by doing A times V, and then computing the QR factorization of that to make the resulting columns of A times V mutually orthonormal again. And then here is that matrix AK, where the matrix AK is, in theory, will eventually become a diagonal matrix if the columns of V become eigenvectors of matrix A. And then if we want to illustrate this, what we do is we extract the diagonal elements of matrix AK from that matrix, and we place those into a column of array lambdas, which is the array that tracks these things. And then if necessary, or if desired, we actually print out these matrices AK to see how the convergence happen. Now the stopping criteria is not really ideal. Here what I do is I look at the strictly lower triangular entries of matrix AK, and if the largest in absolute value of those becomes less than 10 to the minus 14, I decide that I've done enough. And then I've made my the obvious changes to my test driver so that if I go to the command window and I execute test subspace iteration, then I start seeing this matrix AK slowly but steadily becoming a diagonal matrix where we can find the eigenvalues on the diagonal. And when it's all done, we end up with a graph of how this convergence to the various eigenvalues happen. We're tracking three eigenvectors and three eigenvalues here, and they're plotted here, and indeed they converge to the three largest eigenvalues, which is what we expect. And then if we look at a graph where we plot the difference between the final eigenvalue that's computed and the current iteration, then we see that the convergence to the first eigenvalue is faster than the convergence to the second and third eigenvalue. Anyway, that's subspace iteration.